Next example, as we will see, we're starting off in Rhino from a scene with some predefined context and plot and vegetation. We're using the Rhino importer in Spacio. So here we see the visualization of the B-reps and the meshes. And now, as we imported it, we get the context, some DXF reference material, and also the plot that we're testing to generate some building options on. So we select the plot, we launch the building generation tool, and same approach here, we can choose between different types of styles, whether it's like closed courtyard or lamella houses or something more high-rise. We can iterate and test on those parameters of how much openness do we want in the block, what's the density. As we're looking at here, it automatically does apartment mixing. So it places out like all the vertical communications with cores. You manually go in and override the or change the outcomes from the algorithm. So we say we want an opening in this part of the to the courtyard, or where we want to lower like the amount of stories here and so on. So this tools allows you to be again the architect, the person in charge of the design, but having the benefits of that rapid iteration of testing out different variations. And we get those automated like statistics of what does the, how many apartments do we get out, what's the areas. As we're seeing here, a simulation of vertical sky component, which is basically testing out like the what's the potential you have of achieving your the daylight in your building. So it's running in the background live, and while you're changing the shape, you automatically get updates. You see on the left side in the graph if you improved or made it worse from the last iteration. And here we're looking at the whole generative system, where you can basically ask the platform to generate options for you. They get summarized in a parallel coordinate where you see all the different parameters. And on the right side, then you can click, you can choose, pick your favorites. You can see what they then do in performance. You can filter out, for example, say we're not interested in any options that's below a certain threshold in a specific statistic. And then in here we see that you make some manual changes of the buildings, of you want some kind of inclined entry. Here is the whole unit editor where you can change, set up your different target mixes of the units and the target areas. And you can optimize for it, make sure that's where you're hitting the correct fitness level for your unit mix. Now we're currently up at around like 90%. We're also seeing a different simulation for sun hours to see, do we get a lot of like shaded areas in our plot? Where can we build high? Do we need to like open up the courtyard? And also system, as we're seeing here, like when it comes to compliance checks, every change you make in Spacio, it automatically gets checked against local regulations. So what we saw there was like fire safety regulations of that we need to change like the distance between the windows. And in the end, we end up back in Rhino again. So we exported our scene. You get this as fully native BREP format and standard like 3DM file format to continue off your project in there.